The Battle of Gettysburg was fought from July 1st through the July 3rd, 1863, marking a turning point in the American Civil War in the North's favor. George G. Meade, the general, led the North Army of about 90,000 men to victory against General Robert E. Lee's Southern Army of about 75,000. The shooting began when the two forces met accidentally in the town of Gettysburg, Pennsylvania on July 1st. That day, South forces took the town, but Union troops took a strong position on high ground south of town. On July 2nd, Lee tried but failed to break the North's line at points known as Culp's Hill, Cemetery Ridge, the Peach Orchard, the Wheatland, Devil's Den, and Little Round Top. Early on July 3rd, fighting resumed at Culp's Hill on the Union's right. Lee also attacked the Union center on Cemetery Ridge, following an artillery duel of about 13,000 troops organized in part led by General George E. Pickett, advanced across an open field and up Cemetery Ridge in what became known as Pickett's Charge. Facing impossible odds, only a few of the Southern troops reached the top of the ridge. On July 4th, Lee began to withdraw to Virginia. About 4,000 Southerners and more than 3,000 Northerners were killed in the battle. The total number of casualties, those killed, wounded, missing, or captured, was about 23,000 for the North and from 25,000 to 28,000 for the South.
Sir, General McClellan sends his compliments. It's a message for the folks in Washington. Tell them we need reinforcements. Fast. Hurry.
I'll deliver it immediately.
Pray to God we never have to go through a battle like that again.
We could be next to die.
I hope not.
I hope not too.
Hope President Lincoln gets this over with fast.
Thank you. I will not allow this country to be destroyed. Finally, I have a general that fights. You tell me he's not qualified?
We're not saying he's unqualified. We're just saying he may not be the best person for the job.
We haven't seen him succeed at anything.
General Meade is the man. He'll bring victory to this country.
At what cost? He doesn't know when to retreat. He will not retreat. Will you be responsible for the vain deaths of thousands of people?
They are not in vain. They're for a reason. A reason beyond life. A reason for human equality between whites and blacks. In a country that all men are created equal.
Sir, I can see how this war goes beyond just the states seceding from the Union. But how far will we go? At what cost?
There's been many deaths, and they grieve me much. But we have to go through this time. This country has to make it through, and we will.
Sir, a message from Gettysburg.
There is a battle at Gettysburg. Bring in the messenger, please. How did Lee get all the way to Gettysburg?
Well, rumor has it that he was in search of shoes for his men. They clashed with us while we were on the way to Gettysburg and drove us back until we entrenched near the Gettysburg Cemetery 5 days ago. The Confederate Army formed a long, thin line and charged up the ridge where we were located and began picking them off one by one. I bet 2/3 of the men didn't even make it to the top of the ridge.
There's too many of them. Provide more cover.
Many. When I left yesterday, the battle was nearly over. Although the general would not admit, I reckon our remaining army has chased the Confederates all the way back to Virginia by now.
Do you think we won the battle?
Oh yes, there's no question. We drove the Confederates back quite a bit.
Many men were lost?
Yes, many men were lost, but not nearly as many as the Confederates.
I think this shows the beginning of the end of the war. Four score and 7 years ago, our fathers brought forth on this continent, a new nation, conceived in liberty and dedicated to the proposition that all men are created equal. Now, we are engaged in a great civil war, testing whether that nation, or any nation so conceived and so dedicated, can long endure. We are met on a great battlefield of that war. We have come to dedicate a portion of that field as a final resting place for those who here gave their lives that that nation might live. It is altogether fitting and proper that we should do this. But, in a larger sense, we cannot dedicate, we cannot consecrate, but cannot hallow this ground. The brave men, living and dead, who struggled here, have consecrated it far above our poor power to add or detract. The world will little know, nor longer remember what we say here, but it can never forget what they did here. It is for us, the living, rather, to be dedicated here to the unfinished work which they who fought here have thus so far nobly advanced. It is rather for us to be here dedicated to this great task remaining before us, that from these honored dead we take increased devotion to that cause for which they gave the last full measure of devotion, that we here highly resolve that these dead shall not have died in vain, that this nation under God shall have a new birth of freedom, and that government of the people, by the people, for the people, shall not perish from the earth.
That was the Vienna Wood Dance in D, one of my all-time favorites. And now let's make that random call with today's $10,000 question. It's a tough one. Who shot Alexander Hamilton in that famous duel? All right, let's go to the phones and see who's out there.
Hello?
They're coming. Hold your fire. Here they come.
Guys, hold your fire.
Hold your fire.
Now.
Hey, back here, back here. Yeah.
It's the worst battle I've ever seen.
I can't believe it.
Lost my best friend today.
Ready? Okay. We haven't seen him succeed at anything. Blacks and whites. Okay, Cat, send the line over.
How did Lee get all the way to Gettysburg?
I don't know.
Anytime, this thing's rolling.
Yeah, action. No. Okay, Cat.
Men are created equal. That first one was better.